when we moved on to Rutgers Street, Short Rutgers, they called it, there's a one family on our street, and there, that was the Madisons, and it was Rev Madison, who was a part-time minister and a part-time bodyguard or something, and then his wife, Tina, and two kids that were actually their grandchildren that they were taking care of. So it was Vicky, and then there was also Roosevelt, who was a really dear little boy, who at that point I think was about maybe 9 years old. And Roosevelt used to come up to our house, and he and I would look at Time magazine together because he wanted to know about all these people and all these things that he saw in the magazine. So we got to be good pals, and when the Shriner Circus came to town, Paul and I decided we would take Roosevelt with us to the circus, which was being held in the old Bush Stadium, which was an open stadium in a circle that had decks, I guess, up high, fairly high up. So Roosevelt was very excited, and when we got to the stadium, we went in, and of course there were all these vendors standing around with all kinds of junk to sell, and one of the things Roosevelt fixated on was a sword in a scabbard. It looked like probably some sort of Japanese knockoff thing, plastic sword in a scabbard, but he thought it was really cool, so we bought it for him. And we went up and found some seats up in sort of an up in an upper deck. I guess we must have had assigned seats, I'm not sure, but we were right on the front row in this upper deck. So we had a great view of the circus going on down below. And somewhere in the process of the circus, there were all these clowns and things, and they drove up in a little car and started piling out. And a guy in a gorilla suit got out of the car and ran around in the circle in the ring, and everybody cheered. And then with that, the gorilla ran over to the side. We couldn't even see where he was because he was kind of down under us. And all of a sudden, we realized that there was a rope tied to the railing right in front of us, a big, heavy rope. And darn it, this gorilla didn't come climbing up the rope and jump over the railing and land right in front of us. Well, Roosevelt didn't hesitate a minute. He jumped up, pulled the sword out of the scabbard, and went after the gorilla with the sword. And everybody in the audience was cheering. And the gorilla turned around and, of course, you know, made a big production and waved his arms in the air and looked really frightened, and then ran away and went down into the bowels of the Bush Stadium. And that was the end of it. Roosevelt was a hero, and I guess he probably has never forgotten that. I certainly haven't. So that's my story.
Thank you. like the birds in the trees, like the flowers and the bees, but of all those things I like you best of all.
Sally. Thank you. Thank you.